Hello viewers, how are you? Hope you are fine. Welcome to my channel Drawing Time with Story. Today I am going to show you how to draw a candle step by step. And I will tell you a story about candles. So get started. Once upon a time, two candles came to talk to each other. One was made out of wax and it was big and majestic, whereas the other was only made of tallow and had been dipped 8 times in the farthing dip. "I am born of wax and I have a great shape. I am going to a big house. There I will be mounted on a luxurious silver candle stand," the wax candle said. "That must be great," the tallow candle spoke softly. "Well, I will only light up a kitchen. Even that is a good place. After all the food is prepared there. I am content with that." But the wax candle told the tallow candle that there were far greater joys in the world. "Have you ever seen a society shine? Oh, the dazzling, brilliant light they give off." The tallow candle felt jealous for it. Would never feel the society shine. Only brass stands awaited the poor tallow candles. Just then, the candles were picked up and taken away. A lady from a rich house took them to her house. When the lady reached her grand house, a little boy who worked there welcomed her. "There is a candle for you too," the lady exclaimed. "Your mother works hard and late at night. This will help her," she said, handling the tallow candle. Upon hearing this, the lady's daughter said, "I will be up too. There is a ball tonight and I will wear my red sash." The tallow candle saw the little girl's happiness. "Look at her face. Even a candle cannot shine that bright. I am never going to get a chance to see this again. I am going to a poor house where I won't even have a brass stand." After the boy finished his chores, he ran back to his home. Off he ran to his mother and sisters. Upon reaching home, he gave the candle to his mother. "Oh, isn't the lady nice? She always sends us presents," the widow mother said. "The house was small with 2 rooms. It is going to burn all night," saying that she lighted the candle. "She didn't even use a proper match," the tallow candle thought. After all, he still believed the rich house was better off. At the same moment, a little girl came out. "I have something important to tell you, brother," she whispered. "Hot potatoes. We have hot potatoes for dinner." As soon as the girl announced that, her face shone. She looked exactly like the girl from the big house. "Oh," the candle realized. "I see. I am fortunate enough to come here. This girl is happy to have dinner, and I am fortunate enough to give them my light." Looking out of the window, the candle saw carriages take passengers to the rich house. "It must be starting. I can hear the music now," the candle thought. Soon the family prepared the table and sat down. Before digging into food, the little girl offered a prayer. Once the prayer ended, they ate until they were full. The tallow candle thought, "I am glad I came to this house. Not only did I have a good life, I also had the privilege of making this family happy." Hope you enjoyed my story and my drawing too. Please subscribe my channel to stay connected with me for new videos, for new stories or information about the topic I draw. How you feel about my channel, my drawings, let me know in the comment section. Stay safe, stay connected. Bye, see you.